Podcast Network Asia.
So the question now, dahil nga maraming tanong, maraming news na naglalabasan na the actors from season 2 and season 1 have said na parang if there will be season 3, they are willing to participate or to join again. Now the question is, if there is a season 3, would I watch it? Yes.
And that's exactly the reason why I am here today, Pamangkin. Annyeong mga K-drama pamangkin, it's a brand new Tuesday, so a brand new K-drama chismisan. And today's K-drama review is 3 years in the making. So back in February 2020, I released one of my earliest episodes of a K-drama review. And on that episode, which is episode 66, can you imagine? Episode 66, and we are now at episode 235. It has been so long since I've been doing this podcast. So anyway, on episode 66, I talked about the K-drama that was really close to my heart. At that time, it was my fave medical K-drama of all time. So watching season 2 of it was almost like expected of me because I really enjoyed the first season. And now, here we are on its third season. And just like what I said on that audio clip that you just heard earlier from episode 66, if there will be a season 3, would I watch it? My answer was a yes, and I did exactly what I said. And now I am ready to unload my feelings about season 3. Are you ready? It's time, mga pamangkin, to talk about the season 3 of Dr. Romantic. Three years following the events of the second season, Doldam Hospital Regional Trauma Center, which was Kim Sabu's long-held dream, will be opened. With the opening of the Regional Trauma Center, the scale of incidents and accidents that Doldam Hospital has to deal with also increased. And that is just a preview of what you would expect on what will happen on season 3 of Dr. Romantic. And I know this is going to be a spoiler, but I am so happy to spoil this. I am so happy to spoil that the whole team, and I mean the whole team from season 2, is back for another season. And I mean everyone, from the doctors to the nurses to the admin people, and to, of course, my including my super cute na si Mr. Gu, who I really love since season 1. As in, talagang super nakukita na ko sa kanya. And he got some lines this time. So he is also back. And of course, we got our Kim Sabu, played by Han Seok-yu, the amazing Han Seok-yu. And also, the love lines of season 2 are back. So we again have An Yosop, Lee Song-kyung, and my cuties. Ang aking cutie na si Nurse Park, played by Kim Min-jae, and Dr. Yoon, played by So Ju-yeon. Now, I don't know if you can relate to me if you did not watch at least one of the seasons of this Dr. Romantic, but let me just share that I was crying like a baby during the first episode, where one by one they made their first appearance in the new season and I finally see all of them again. I don't know, I'm a tita, but I cried like a baby on the first episode. I guess I was just really so happy to see everyone, even the paramedics. The paramedics that would bring the patients to the hospital. Those guys that were on season 1, season 2, they got to play their roles again on the season 3. And all of those, just really too much. It really made me cry at 11 p.m. habang kumakain po ako ng chips. Umiiyak po ako. Hindi ko alam. I guess I just didn't realize that I miss Dr. Romantic until I watched it again. Like, I know I have some issues with season 2, but when I was watching season 3, I cannot help but really cried my eyes out. It was so nostalgic, especially when the team got reunited with Dr. Kang Dong-ju, played by my number 3 oppa, na si Yoon Yoo-suk. I mean, I cried harder when they finally got reunited. Hindi ko alam kung anong nangyari. I mean, it's not something so tragic. It's not a medical scenario that was so tragic. It's just them reuniting with Dr. Kang and yun. Umiyak na po ako. Toto po ako iyak. And I even shared, I think I shared a snip of it on Instagram because again, I was just really so happy. So I think maririnig mo lang dun sa background is ako umiiyak. Kasi tuwang-tuwa po ako. And again, unless I guess you watch at least the season one of Dr. Romantic, I don't know if you will be able to relate to me. You may not be able to see how big of a deal it was for me and why I am so happy that I finally got to see again Dr. Kang. Kasi sa season 2, parang nami-mention lang sila. There was, I think, a phone call, but not really something that we heard their voices. So, finally, he was able to join the team for just even a little bit of season 3. So, I was really so happy. And I know, I'm so sorry. I know that is a major spoiler, but please, pagbigyan nyo na ako. Kasi hindi ko talaga makontain yung happiness ko. When I finally got to see again Yoon Yoon-suk, there was a discussion about it. There were rumors about it, but until the season actually aired, it was not really confirmed. So, oh, thank God. It's true. It is true. Now that I have spoiled you on that, and let me continue with it, let me spoil the K-drama more. So again, continue listening at your own risk. Okay, mga pamangkin? So, kung hindi mo pa napapanood ang K-drama and you hate spoilers, you want to stop now. Okay? You may want to stop now. Make sure to watch the K-drama before you listen back to this episode. But if you're not bothered by any spoilers that I will give, then let's continue to talk about it. Now, let me break down this season to what I think went right and what I think did not really go right, or what I think went wrong with season 3. Let's of course start with the good things. So let's start with the things that went right for season 3. Number one na dyan sa listahan ko talaga. Number one on my list is the character played by the Ajushi. And that's a juicy. Played by Kim Jo-hun. Na si Dr. Park Min-guk. So, Dr. Park Min-guk already was included on season 2. He was first introduced last season. So, he is now the official head or president of Doldam Hospital. And I don't know if you have ever listened to my previous episode, but I had a huge beef or issue with his character on season 2. My main issue back then was that he was portrayed. He was introduced to the series or to the story as the new main villain. Iba yung villain kasi sa season 1. Sa season 2, medyo sub-villain na rin siya. Sub-villain na lang siya. And this Dr. Park Min-guk was supposed to take over his seat sa impyerno. So, yun nga. So, para siyang introduced to the series, the season 2, as the new villain of the season. But throughout season 2, he was not as good as the villain of season 1. So, hindi siya kasing sama ni season 1 villain. But at the same time, he's not also a good guy. So, he's just like somewhere in between, very vague yung character. So, like what I said on my K-drama review of season 2, he was like a wallflower that was there, but because it is unclear what his actual role is or his character, he was there but felt like he wasn't. So, para siyang wallflower, wallpaper, whatever you call it. background lang talaga si kuya mo sa season 2. And I hated that because I know it was just a matter of the writers or the people behind the scene coming up with a better layout of a story for him. Hindi lang talaga maganda yung pagkakasulat sa kanya sa season 2. And thank God talaga, with season 3, he finally has a clear role in the series. So, meron na talaga siyang, ito yung role niya. Okay? Hindi na siya vague na hindi mo malaman kung kalaban siya, kakampi, or whatever. So, season 3, he finally has a clear role in the story. He has a much better role in season 3. I felt his presence in the K-drama and he was amazing on some of his scenes. I was looking forward to his contribution to the team and his sneaky ways to help the team. And that was actually really good for him. I'm really happy of how his character turned out in this new season. So if ganun din yung issue mo sa kanya by nung season 2, I am happy to spoil that he is definitely so much better by on season 3. Okay? Kasi dati talaga, parang pinipilit siyang maging villain pero hindi siya up to that role. So, para siyang saling pusa sa villain role. So, he was not effective for his role and at the same time, he's not also a good guy na you will remember. Just like, for example, ang ating favorite anesthesiologist. Na he's definitely a good guy. You know, he was always supporting Dr. Or Kim Sabo. So he's neither of those. Which again makes his role very vague. And I hated that. I hate that with a K-drama on any stories that I am watching or reading. Next on my list. Okay, second on my list that season 3 did write. For me, okay, again, this is just me. For me, there was a perfect balance between the drama of the characters, the office politics, and the medical scenes, or the medical drama. With season 1 kasi, with season 1, it was heavy on the character drama, which is, you know, expected because they're still establishing the characters. They're still trying to introduce to us who is Kim Sabo, how did he end up being like that, or his background, basically the drama of his life. So I expected that from season 1. And then it was also heavy on office politics. That was actually the main dilemma or the main problem on season 1. On season 2 naman kasi, on season 2, they leaned more on the medical drama. Those were where you can find those very, very heartbreaking medical scenes. Nakakaantig puso talaga. As in, iyak ako ng iyak sa season 2. And it was mainly because, again, of the medical conditions or the medical scenarios that were portrayed in the story. So each episode, they would have a different case. And everything is very dramatic. So talagang masakit sa puso. With season 3... For me, it just has enough or a balanced portrayal of an office politics. May drama pa rin yung mga characters. And there was also enough drama in the medical side. So the medical scenarios, the medical situations that were portrayed on every episode were still something worth watching. It is definitely heartbreaking, eye-opening. Lahat na ng description na pwede nyo magawa. Nandun na sa season 3. So, for me, it has enough balance. So, hindi siya too much office politics, office or the character drama. Tapos, hindi rin naman siyang sobra-sobrang focus sa mga medical dramas. Nakalimutan na yung character development ng mga characters niya. So, for me, season 3 found that balance between all of those. And it was really well-written for me. For season 3, it was definitely well-written. I wouldn't still consider it the best among all three of them because I would still be biased to the first season. Because again, if the first season wasn't good, then I wouldn't even go up to season 2. So, I would still say, lamang pa rin sa akin ang season 1. But definitely, season 3 is a close fight to season 1. Definitely much better than season 2. Okay. Thank God talaga. Because that was my problem. Kasi sabi ko, I think I mentioned this on the episode 66 for the season 2. I did mention that my worry is if the writers continue with this type of writing, kasi nga I hated season 2, I was predicting that season 3 would be just like so much worse than season 2 and the series would just go downhill from there. And that was what I was thinking. That was my worry back then. Anyway, good thing that did not happen. They were able to bounce back with season 3, so I'm happy to spoil that. Last for me of what went right with season 3 is the love story of the characters of Ahn Hyosop and Lee Song Kyung. Kasi back in season 2 talaga, I did mention that one of the letdowns of season 2 is the love story of the supporting leads. So in season 1, so we've got Yeon Yoo-suk and nakalimutan ko name ni Ate Girl. Hala, teka lang. I can remember this. Oh my gosh, I forgot. Oh, So Hyun-jin, yon. So season 1 kasi the love line between the two characters of Yoon Yoo-suk, they had an amazing chemistry. Sa season 2 kasi, with Ahn Hyosop and Lee Song Kyung taking over the love line, hindi talaga siya sa akin. I'm so sorry. I know there are people out there that love the chemistry, but I, again, could be different. I could have a different idea compared to yours. I have a different background, different childhood. Ang defensive ko na. But anyway, again, for me, it did not work. Season 2 was really a letdown compared to season 1, where I really enjoyed the good chemistry between Yoon Yoon-suk and So Hyun-jin. Sa season 2 kasi, I just wasn't feeling it. I did not feel the chemistry. I still think that Ahn Hyosop's portrayal on this Dr. Romantic is too dramatic. Ewan ko, hindi ko talaga alam kung bakit. Pero parang out of all his characters, out of all the characters in this series, siya yung parang palagi siyang sinukluban ng langit at lupa. I know his backstory in this K-drama is really dark. It's very, very painful yung pinagdaanan niya. But I think it's just like, parang ang drama ni kuya mo. Hindi siya parang feeling ko pang ano siya eh, yung mga parang penthouse, sky castle type of drama. Pero hindi siya yung parang mga medical. Anyway, that's just again me. Fortunately, na-balance out na siya dito sa season 3. It's still very dramatic. Palagi pa rin siyang parang pinagsukluban ng langit at lupa. But medyo toned down na siya. Season 2 kasi parang si kuya mo talaga, ano siya eh, parang wala nang mabuting nangyari sa buhay niya. But anyway, yeah. So fortunately, it is so much better. Their characters, their chemistry is so much better. So for me, with season 3, they are still definitely second to the chemistry of, again, Yoon Yoon-suk and So Hyun-jin of season 1. But so much better than their initial love story on season 2. So much better. I don't know, for some reason this time it worked. Season 1, I didn't feel it. Now, obviously, if there are things that went right with season 3, there are, of course, some things that did not really go so well with season 3, of course. Okay? There's always something good. There's something that could have been improved. And number one on that is, I hate the development of the love story of Nurse Park and Dr. Yoon. Season 2 kasi, they were the best love line for me. So much better than the main love line, which again, as I've mentioned, I did not feel the chemistry of Ahn Hyosop and Lee Song Kyun's character. I did not really like them. I did not love their love line. I did not really even want to watch them. I probably have skipped some of their scenes. So, yung kilig ko napunta sa kina Dr. Yoon and Nurse Park, and they were very cute. They were very, very cute on season two. But I hate that they were not able to keep that cute love story on season 3. Yes, I know being in a relationship is not always cute. It's not always a bed of roses. Okay? Kung ano pang mga idiomatic expressions na gusto nyo maisip, yun na yun. Okay? So I know it's not always happy-happy. There will be some issues that the couple have to go through just to, you know, portray that their relationship is also evolving. But I just think that their love story in season 3 was not well written. So nagkabaliktad ata yung writers nung nung yung mga writers na gumawa ng love story sa, ng season 1 ni An Yosop and Lee Song Kyung. Feeling ko sila nang take over sa love story ni Nurse Park and Dr. Yoon. I don't know. I have no idea what's going on with their mind, but the season 3 of their love story, it's a letdown. Oh my god. I just didn't really like it. It was a letdown for me. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. If you also feel the same way, let me know. At least I would know that it's not something na ako lang ang nakakaramdam. And there are other people that also didn't like how their story ended in season 3. I mean, I can think of several ways of them showing that their relationship have evolved, or kumbaga may laman na yung kwento nila this season 3. It's just that, ewan ko, hindi ko alam kung bakit pangit ang pagkakasulat ng love story nila sa season 3. And another letdown for me is, again, the character of Dr. Bae, the orthopedic surgeon. It's actually the same as season 2. Nothing has changed with his role in season 3, which again is the main reason why it's a letdown. He was, again, unfortunately, more like a wallpaper or a wallflower. I don't even know. Is it wallflower or wallpaper? But anyway, you get what I mean. For a minute, okay? For a minute, na-excite sana ako eh. I thought there was something finally happening with them, with Dr. Yoon and Dr. Bae, nung yung sa airport or sa airplane scene, diba? Yung sa season, episode 1 ata yun. But of course, that is not the case. So he was again back to just being an extra. And I really, really feel bad about that. I really feel bad for him because his character from season 2 never progressed in the story. Parang wala na siyang involvement. Parang bigyan niyo naman ng drama si Kuya. Now, if there will be a season 4, I am begging the K-drama deities, K-drama lords out there to please guide our writers to come up with more interesting thing happening for him. I'm pretty sure there's at least one story that we can look forward involving Dr. Bae. Doesn't have to be focused on him. It can be just, you know, a love triangle or something else. Gaya nga ng suggestion ko from episode 66. Gawin nyo nang parang ano siya, biglang naging super guapo nung nawala yung glasses. All of the nurses, all of the patients will fall in love with him. Parang ganun. Bigyan nyo naman ng interesting thing si kuya mo. Wallflower na naman. Wallpaper? Wallflower? Basta, yun. Na naman siya. Now, the last one, and I don't really know if I can really say that this is a letdown of season 3. So I let you be the judge on this, okay? I just noticed that comparing his character from season 1 to 3, here on season 3, our Kim Sabo, our beloved Kim Sabo, is more calm and collected. I think I even noted that from episodes 1 to 3, he seemed like he has softened up. And I really thought it was part of, you know, his character development. Kasi nga naman, di ba? It's been 7 years, okay? In reality, it's been 7 years since season 1. So naturally, kung pa-follow natin yung years na yon, naturally, the character in the story would have also grown or aged. So, akala ko talaga parang lumambot na siya. Kasi nga, matanda na. Parang ganun. But oh my God, I think it was episode 3 or 4. There was a scene where Kim Sabo had a major confrontation with this newbie cutie Dr. Jung. And he went all off. He went off on him and like humbled him down. That it really reminded me of the Kim Sabo, of the hot-headed, confrontational Kim Sabo that I really loved from season 1. was torn at the start nung sa character niya sa season 1 kasi napaka-confrontational and hot-headed ni Kuya Mo. But it eventually warmed up on me. So I really thought he was back. But his character in the story didn't mature. But he is still the old Kim Sabo. So there are some scenes where you can you're reminded of the season 1 Kim Sabo. And at the same time, you're also seeing a new, better version number 3 of Kim Sabo. So I don't know if I can categorize this as a good thing or a bad thing for season 3. So I'll just let you decide on that. Now, speaking of the cutie newbie doctor. So here on season 3, we got introduced to two new doctors. We got Dr. Jung and the ex-military doctor, Dr. Lee. Played by Lee Sun-yong and Lee Hong-nae, respectively. Lee Sun-yong is the cutie pie from Crash Landing on You. I don't know if anyone remembers him, but he was the only guy that really looked good to sa mga North Korean soldiers na ano na subordinates ni Yoon Bin, ng character ni Yoon Bin. And Lee Hong-nae, who I cannot believe this when I tried to research who he was or his previous role. I cannot believe that he is the guy that was possessed by an evil spirit or spirit in the Uncanny Counter. Siya po yung ano, semi-kalbo na tumatalon-talon building to building dun. Siya po yun. If you don't believe me, you can also check it out. I also didn't believe it. I had to find a picture of him being in Uncanny Counter, if it's really him. But it is actually him. So, about these two guys over here, I think they are really a good addition to the series. Definitely a much needed young blood in the series. I would say that Lee Sun-yong was very effective in his role as the immature, self-centered, annoying resident. Ramdam mo yung gigil ko, no? Kasi nanggigil po talaga ako sa kanya. So he was effective. And Lee Hong-nae, being an innocent and naive ex-military doctor, is so cute. Ang cute ng character niya dito. Together, these two young men, they balance the scenes. And if there will be a season 4 and they will again play their roles, I hope that the writers would give us more of the bromance between the two. I would love to see them having fun, watching each, helping each other. And I really like that particular episode. I cannot remember what episode it is. Yung nagchichismisan sila. Yung parang may nangyayari sa mga kasamahan nila. And being the new guys in the team. So they were trying to figure it out without actually asking. Para hindi sila magmukhang chismoso. So they were just, you know, consulting with each other kung ano sa tingin nila ang nangyayari, bakit nangyayari mga kaganapan. So it was actually fun watching them. I definitely love their addition to the team. And I look forward to seeing them if there will ever be a season 4. And on the subject of season 4, so if you ask me again if I would watch season 4 of Dr. Romantic, if, for example, there will be a season 4, I would still say yes. I think Dr. Romantic is still one of the best K-dramas out there. Not just one of the best medical K-drama, one of the best K-drama in general for me. Okay? The K-drama was definitely written with so much passion. I can definitely, again, I am just being dramatic maybe, but to me, I really felt the heart and soul that the writers, the people behind the scene put into this series or in this K-drama. I can really feel it. I can feel the message, their intentions, the intentions of the writers with every episode, with every medical scenarios that they portrayed in the story. Ramdam ko yung puso eh. Ramdam ko yung yung puso, yung passion nila sa pagsusulat ng kwento. And that definitely makes it as one of the best K-dramas for me. And it is still one of the best produced medical K-drama. Maybe second to Hospital Playlist, but definitely one of the best out there. I am still amazed by the quality of the props, the set, Oh my God. And whenever I watch the them operating, I don't feel like I'm watching a K-drama, but I feel that I'm watching a video of an actual operation with real life doctors, with real life patient. So yung pakiramdam ko. So it's still one of the best produced medical K-drama. Second to hospital playlist. Konti lang yung lamang ng hospital playlist, pero in terms of props, sets, halos pantay na rin sila eh. Now, the music with the old songs, yun yung kasing medyong addition sa Dr. Romantic, because nga old si Kim Sabo is an old soul. Well, he's really old. There are of course inclusions of old songs, old Korean songs in the K-drama, and I still find them really good, and I still think that they fit the K-drama overall feels. So I really like them. Also, again, I love the well-written supporting characters. The doctors, the nurses, even the supporting characters, the paramedics. I love the supporting characters of this K-drama. All of these big and small reasons, for me, if you add them up, that made it easy for me to say yes to a season 4. But going back to season 3, okay? Focus muna tayo sa season 3. Would I... your K-drama tita recommend this K-drama to you even if you have not watched any of the previous seasons? I would still say yes. It is one of the best medical series out there, so I don't want you to miss on that. Just because of that, I would still recommend this. Obviously, there would be some jokes and scenes that may escape you, so hindi mo magigets yung iba, because again, you did not watch any of the previous seasons. But I would say they don't really affect your overall experience watching the K-drama. So I am confident that you would still enjoy season 3 of Dr. Romantic even if you have not watched season 1 or 2. If you have watched seasons 1 and 2 and you are still on the fence if you should watch season 3, then trust this K-drama tita of yours. Season 3 is so worth it. If season 2 made you feel that the K-drama is going downhill just like me, trust me, they were able to bounce back with season 3. I'm happy to report that season 3 is so much better. And so, if I would rate this K-drama on a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being the highest, I would give this Dr. Romantic season 3 a 9.5. The K-drama continues to warm your heart with different medical stories and stories of people working in the medical field. So it also is not afraid to open your eyes to social issues. That's also something that you will get from this K-drama. And again, if you have been a fan of the series from season 1, this season 3 is like a homecoming episode or homecoming special that will definitely wrap it beautifully for you and will definitely melt your heart. So much so that I am actually torn if I would still want a season 4 for Dr. Romantic. Okay, if there will be, okay, yes, I will definitely watch it. But would I want a season 4? I'm actually not sure. I think season 3 was really good. It was a really good season to wrap up the whole story of Kim Sabo and the people of Doldam Hospital. I am honestly afraid that if they decide to go with another season, that they may not do it as good as season 3. As for a succeeding season of a K-drama, I am afraid that what they would do with season 4, it would not be as good as season 3, that they should have ended with season 3. And, you know, I'm just really scared that they may ruin this, assuming the happy ending that we all assumed that the people of Doldam happened or were able to get. So, I don't know. I'm just really scared that they may ruin the happy ending that we imagine that happened to Kim Sabo and the Doldam Hospital. So I'm really torn. I just hope that if they decide to do a season 4, that they would really take their time I don't care if it again takes another 3 years. If pwedeng two, okay, much better. But I don't really care if they go for another 3 years as long as they can promise me that it would be so much better than season 3. And this will finally be wrapped up beautifully. Walang mamatay. Diyos ko, Lord. Yan talaga yung kinakabahan ko. Sabi ko talaga, if my season 3, baka mamatay na si Kim Sabo. Kasi usually ganun nangyayari eh. By the last season, it will be the final season of the K-drama. Tapos, dyan na yung namamatay yung mga ano, yung mga bida. So, yun po talaga yung kabang-kaba po ako. And hindi pa, iniiwasan ko pa naman makakita ng mga spoilers. O, diba? Ang ironic, ako nagbibigay ng spoilers sa inyo. Pero ako, ayoko ng spoilers. Pero yun nga, iniiwasan ko yung spoilers kasi sabi ko, ayokong ma-disappoint. Ayokong, kumbaga, ayokong makakita ng ikaka-biyak ng puso ko. So, I was staying away from social media as, or looking out for any spoilers. I was really avoiding them. So anyway, that's just me. Again, the 16 episodes of Dr. Romantic Season 3 is available for streaming on Disney Plus. Oh, nagulat din kayo, no? Nagulat din ako na nasa Disney siya. Like I said in my previous episode, lumalaban na po si Antinyo Disney. So it's not just Netflix. It's no longer just VU versus Netflix. Disney is also joining. They know that they have a huge market for K-drama. And they are getting better and better with the K-dramas that they produced and those that they actually buy the streaming rights, just like Dr. Romantic. Now again, everything that I said here are all of my opinions. It does not reflect. Wala naman palang reflect. So all of this, all of the things that I've said earlier or everything in this podcast is just my opinion. That could again be totally different from yours. And that's okay. We are all unique. And I would love to know about your thoughts as well. So if you can let me know through any of my social media accounts on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, it's all at Anyong Tita. And with that, good night, kids. I love you, Bruno Mars.
Samnida, thank you for listening to this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to rate us 5 stars. And if you want to be updated, make sure to follow the podcast, hit the notification bell, and also follow me at Anyong Tita on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram so you won't miss out on anything. And catch our weekly deep dive K-drama conversations every Tuesday on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or other podcast streaming platforms here at your favorite K-drama show with your favorite K-drama tita. Annyeong tita!